In this video, we're going to cover some of the important vitamins and minerals that act as coenzymes within glycolysis and the Krebs cycle. Without these coenzymes, the two bioenergetic systems cannot operate at their peak performance. This video is going to be slightly different than previous videos, but only slightly. We are also going to cover the application of the specific knowledge of vitamins and minerals, bringing up examples of foods that would serve as good sources of these particular metabolic essentials. The vitamins that we'll cover are four of the B vitamins: B1 or thiamine, B2 or riboflavin, B3 or niacin, and B6 or pyridoxine. All four of these B vitamins are found in large quantities in meat, fish, and poultry. But if you are a vegetarian, starches and grains are often fortified with B1 and B2, and dark greens are a good source of B3 and B6. Please note that these aren't the only sources, but we don't want to bog you down with all the possibilities. This is just to give you a rough idea of where they likely can be found in the best quantities. The minerals that we'll cover are iron, manganese, and magnesium. Iron can be found in meats and leafy greens, manganese can be found in whole grains, and magnesium can be found in nuts and legumes. Again, these aren't the only sources. There are many more, but this is just to have a single visualization for the sake of time and sanity. Within glycolysis, there is really only one important vitamin that we will discuss, and that is B6, or pyridoxine. This vitamin is used during the breakdown of glycogen into glucose-1-phosphate. Therefore, B6 is essential to the start of glycolysis when glycogen is being used more than glucose. After glycolysis, remember that pyruvate must be turned into acetyl-CoA before going into the Krebs cycle. This reaction receives help from three different vitamins: B1 or thiamine, B2 or riboflavin, and B3 or niacin. In fact, the NAD that is transformed actually stands for niacinamide, which is closely associated with vitamin B3. Another reaction where the same three B vitamins are used is the conversion of alpha-ketoglutarate into succinyl-CoA. Vitamin B2 or riboflavin is used once more in the reaction that creates FADH2. Next is the minerals. Iron is used for two reactions, the citrate to isocitrate reaction and the succinate to fumarate reaction. The reaction of isocitrate into alpha-ketoglutarate is aided by the mineral manganese. And the reaction of succinyl-CoA into succinate is aided by magnesium. For the next class, you will be expected to know all of the vitamins and minerals that play a part in these two energy systems, which specific reactions they facilitate, and what specific foods mentioned above are good sources of these vitamins.